Hello students, today I am going to discuss about one of the important topic in business law, that is essentials of a valid contract. As per section 10 of Indian Contract Act, contract defined as follows: an agreement which is enforceable by law. Now I'll discuss about what are the essentials of a valid contract. First one, plurality of parties. There must be at least two parties to enter into an agreement. One, the party one who make an offer is called as offerer. The other party one who accept the offer is called as offeree. It is not possible to enter into contract by a single person. Second one, offer and acceptance. When a one party signifies to another his willingness to do or to abstain from doing something with a view to obtaining the consent of the other party for such act or abstinence, he is said to make an offer. When it is accepted as it is, that is called as acceptance. To call an offer as valid offer, it must conform to the rules of Indian Contract Act of 1872. The offer must be, or you can say the terms of the offer must be definite, communicated to offeree in a prescribed manner. At the same time, it must be absolute. At the same time, acceptance must be according to the mode prescribed and must be absolute and unconditional and must be communicated to the offerer in the prescribed manner. For example, if X wants to sell his bike to Y for ₹20,000, the Y has to accept as it is. If he is going to give the cross offer, then it is not valid under Contract Act. So there must be a valid offer and acceptance, and it must follow all the terms and conditions which is mentioned in Indian Contract Act of 1872. Third one, intention to create legal obligation. When there is an agreement, there must be an intention among both the parties to create legal relationship or legal obligation. If there is no intention to create legal obligation, it is not constitute a valid agreement and valid contract. For example, any such agreement which is of domestic or social nature cannot be considered as valid contract because there is no intention to create legal obligation. Say, when there is an agreement between father and son to give the pocket money, here as there is no legal obligation, it does not constitute legal obligation. Because of that, it's not a valid contract. So it was well explained in Balfour versus Balfour case. Fourth one, lawful consideration. It is explained in section 23. Every agreement, if it is concerned, if it is followed by, supported by lawful consideration, then only it becomes a valid contract. So what is consideration? Giving something and getting something in return. So it need not necessarily be in cash or kind. It may be an act or abstinence or promise to do or not to do something. The consideration may be past, present or future, and it must be real and lawful. Say, if there is an agreement between the parties where one party promise other party not to file a case, even it is also considered as lawful consideration. Selling of a bike for ₹20,000, here the consideration in the form of cash, even that is also a valid consideration, or you can say lawful consideration. Next one, capacity of the parties to enter into an agreement. Here, whenever an agreement entered by the parties, the parties must have certain capacities or capable of entering into an agreement. Now question arises, what is the capacity of the party to enter into an agreement, or who are all capable of entering into an agreement? There are three categories under this. One is the parties must be the age of majority, in the sense minor is incapable of entering into an contract. He is incapable of entering into a contract. Only the person who has attained the age of 18 can enter into the contract. And the person of sound mind, that is the person who is of unsound mind, is incapable to enter into the contract. Similarly, the person who is not disqualified from contracting by any law to which they are subject. So capacity of the parties enter into an agreement classified into three: the person who has attained the age of majority, who is of sound mind, and who is not disqualified from contracting by any law to which they are subject. If these three parties are capable of entering into contract, others, that is minor, the person who is of unsound mind, and who is disqualified from entering into a contract by any law, they are not capable of entering into an agreement. If they are entering into an agreement, that is not enforceable by law. Now, today in this video, we have discussed 5 points. Remaining points will be discussed in the next video. Thank you for listening.